Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel again, and in this video we will see how can we implement pull to refresh, which is kind of you can say a very quite general practice when using list view. So we will say how we will see how we can implement that, and we'll also see what are the different properties it has. So let's start with a new project, and this time we will use Android Studio. This is not like Visual Studio will not work or something like that. This is just random, so some projects I should make in that, and some in Android Studio, because many of you must be using Android Studio. So here we will select the new Flutter application. Now we can also give it a name, so let's give it a Flutter refresh, and we are good to go. So we have this emulator, or you can say simulator, on the right hand side, and we are having our Flutter project on the left hand side. And I will also tell you about the best practices which you should do in every video. So you have to, you know, keep listening to whatever I am saying, so that you never miss such things. Like just wait for a few seconds and we'll start writing the code, and also I'll share some views. So this is our boilerplate code which we get by Flutter. And guys, so as I told you that I'll always discuss some things to, you know, how can you improve your code, how can you improve writing your code. So one more thing is that guys, whenever you are writing a code, let me just make it a little bit zoomer. So you have to go through this line, which you can see this vertical line on the where my cursor is right now, this one. I don't know if it is available to you or not, it is visible to you or not, but on the right hand side where no code is written, there is a line, a very thin line. So you should always try to write the code which does never crosses this line. Okay, like if I write this code here, after restarted, you can see it crossed this line. Okay, but it should not cross this line, because it will be a better practice to, you know, always do formatting with your code. So that is something which is a good practice to do. Okay, so when you format the code, you will see automatically what it will do. It will just change this to second line. And also I have installed a plugin which will always give you this whenever I press a key, it will be shown in the bottom. Okay, so let's start with the video now. So we have this boilerplate code which we don't want to use, so I'm just writing the code again. Okay, so it will not take so much time, and this time we are going to use Dart 2. Okay, so it's totally your choice, although, but I'll prefer that you use whatever you feel comfortable with. Like there can be some bugs also, so you don't have to worry about them if you are using. And also guys, I have always discussed about how to, you know, create your project. So that is something which actually is not needed from now on. So maybe I will try to not start the project from scratch. So that is different thing. Here you can see this boolean, which is debug show checked mode banner, which is false, which means that the debug ribbon on the top, you always see when you debug your application for the first time, which it will not be shown if I will set it to false. Okay, and then we can have this home, let's call it we don't need a new when we are using Dart 2, but again you can use it, it will not broke your code. Okay, so now we have, let's have a stateful widget, and let's give it a name, home page. Okay, so now we are ready. Let's just a little bit minimize it. Okay, so we have this container and everything. So now what we will do, we will first of all make a list out of it. So for making a list, what I'm going to do, I'm going to have a variable, let's say list. Okay, then I have a variable, another variable which is random. Now let's import some more libraries. First one I want to import is Dart async. Another one I want to import is you can say Dart math. So Dart math is basically for performing mathematical operations. So I will use random class to generate some random number. So that we will get from this math package. And async is basically for using future and everything. So we will use that also. So we have this thing. Now let's override the init state method. And let's just what we can do, we can just remove this code from here and we should write it right behind here. So it's totally your choice wherever you want to write. Now here we have the access to init state, so we will use this init state. And here what we can do, we can say list is equal to new, or you can skip the new. So here you can say generate, okay, so it will ask for the length. So now what I can do, let's do one thing. Here we can say random is equal to random, which is the library which we get with the math package. So we have this random. Now for generate takes two things. First one is the length and second one is the function. So we can write here random dot next int, okay, and here we can say like we want to generate from 0 to 10 or number. So that is why I have written random dot next int. Now it takes a function which is a generator function. So here we can say it will pass I as the output, and here I can write item dollar I. Okay, so it will give me a list. Now here in the container, what we need to use, let's say first of all we will use this scaffold, and inside this scaffold what we are going to do, first of all we will have an app bar, and we can give it a title with a text, and here we can say pull to refresh, okay. And now we can have a body, and the first thing is that you need to use refresh indicator as a parent of your child. Wherever you will use the list view, the parent should be refresh indicator to show the loading icon and at the top or at the bottom, it's all your choice. So here you can see, let's go to refresh indicator once, and here you can see creates a refresh indicator. And it also states what's the advantage of it, how much pixel it takes, everything is written there. And this also tells you what kind of tree it will make. So the refresh indicator will be stacked on top of its child. The indicator will appear when the child is scrollable, descended, is over scrolled. So that is all you can read here. So now we have the refresh indicator. It takes a key, a child, and on refresh. After that you have this notification predicate and everything. So right now we will use this child first of all, and here we can say list view dot builder, let's say, okay. And this builder will give us a dynamic list. So first of all let's give it the item count. So let's say list, then I am using this question mark. This question mark we use if we have some kind of idea, like this list can be null, so then we use this question mark. Although our list as of now is not going to be null, but still it's a better practice to use it. And then we can say dot length. Now we have this item builder. It takes two parameters, one is the context and second one the index. And now here I can say I want a list tile, okay. And in the list tile there will be a title where I can say text, and I will access the ith element of the list, and then I can say to string, or it is already a string so we don't have to worry about it. So this is what we need to do. And now if I will run this application, so let's see what will happen. And again guys, till the time the application is running, let me just tell you that we also have a repository known as Flutter example apps, where you will find all the example applications with their YouTube link and their source code. The link will be available in the description, please check that out. And also our Facebook community is growing day by day, so you can ask your questions there also. I'll try to answer your question there. And as you will see that I have already talked about many things on the group. I always share not just Flutter news but any technological news which is like something trending. So I'll share that on the Facebook group. So you can join that group by using the link in this description. So as you can see that we have some kind of this issue, and right now let's open the terminal or logcat. Basically now we have this run. Okay, so here in the run we will see what kind of issue we got. So you can see that on refresh is not equal to null is not true. So basically we need to also define the on refresh. Okay, so what we can say here, we can go out of this and here we can say on refresh. Okay, so let's say it is null as of now. Now let's refresh this list, let's see what happens. And it again failed. Okay, and it should not be null, by the way. So what we can do, we can make a method now on the top. Let's just disable it for the time being so that you can get a better view. So here what we can do, so this let's talk about this on refresh. Let's go to the code and you can see that it takes a future. Okay, future must complete when the refresh operation is finished. So you need to be sure that whichever function you are making, that should return a future. Okay, so what we can do, that is why we have imported this async library, which is automatically deleted by this IDE, although we don't have to worry about that. So now what we can say here future, and as of now we can give this null parameter because we are not going to return something, and we can name it as refresh list. Okay, and here what we can do, we can refresh our list. Okay, so let's say what we can do, let's copy this line of code, although you should not, but let's regenerate the list. And what other thing we can do, we can also set the state so that our list can be rebuilt, and then we can return null because we don't actually have to return anything. Okay, so now if you will run this code again, let's see what happens. So it will again take some time and it should fix by now. Let's see what happens. Okay, it will take some time again. Okay, it is again giving the issue, which is like it is regarding to refresh indicator. Sometimes it is like, wow, what happened actually. So we again got some kind of issue. I don't know what kind of issue it is, but it is related to the refresh indicator class. Have we messed with this class? Let's see. No, actually. So what's the issue? I don't know. So on refresh. Okay, so this is still null, sorry. So we need to refresh the list. So we will call here refresh list method, and now bang. So it should work now. Let's restart the app. Okay, now you can see guys, we have these four items, which is actually which is randomly generated. So if I will refresh the list, it will regenerate these items. So let's pull this and let's see what happens. Okay, so guys, you can see item is refreshed but the indicator is still showing, and we don't want that, right? So we'll see what's the issue. So let's we have seen that it has given us the exception that this callback returned null and everything, blah blah blah. So we don't have to worry about that as well. What we can do, let's go here and let's rerun the app. First of all, that's the first priority, right? So we have this list, let's refresh it again. And if list is changing, there's no issue with that. But this indicator is still running. So what we can do guys, we can here say that this is a asynchronous type of method. Now here we can make some kind of delay here. So we can say here await future dot delayed. Okay, Now it will ask for a duration, how much time you want to delay it. So you can use new, or if you don't want to do, then now here we can give it some seconds. Like let's say after 2 seconds I want a delay of 2 seconds. So that's what we can do. Now let's rebuild this application and see what happens. So it will take few seconds. Okay, we have the list with 5 items. Now refresh it and you will see only after 2 seconds list will updated and this problem is fixed. Now our indicator is working fine, I guess. Okay, so this time the list is not updated because the random number would be 4, and now you can see the random number is 8. So our list is properly working, our refresh indicator is working. Now let's talk about some more things. Like it may be possible that you don't want to just pull the screen only, then only you want to refresh the list. It may be like if you have some kind of button, then you would like to rebuild the screen or show that indicator. So let's say if I just restart this app again, and at the first time, let's say you want to see here the indicator. So what you can do? Okay, so let's talk about that. For that, what you can do, you can make a global key. Okay, so we can say key and refresh key, we can say it. So refresh key, it will be a global key. Okay, and the type will be, generic will be the refresh indicator state. Okay, so it will give us the state every time, anytime basically. And now here in the refresh indicator, it takes a key, so we can pass this key also. Okay, and refresh key. Now when we initialize this here, rather than doing this random generate, what we can say, we can directly call the refresh list here. Okay, and here what we will do, here we can use this refresh key, okay, and call it set a current state. So it will give us the current state. Okay, wait a second. Okay, alright, why it is not working? This should work, right? I don't know what's the problem. Let's make it a war, or we can say it's a global key, or whatever you want to say. Okay, so here let's call the refresh key dot current state and dot, you have this method which is show. Okay, so it will show the indicator here. So we will use this question mark for if it is null, so it can be null at the first. So let's just rebuild the application. And now you will see this pull to refresh, and then the list appeared. Okay, so let's run it again, and you will see that this refreshing loading indicator, and then the list will be shown. And after that, what we can do, we have this one more property at top. We can make it false, then the indicator will be shown at the bottom. Let me just show you. And if I will rebuild this app, then you will see that here is the indicator at the top, at the bottom. So this is how you can implement this. And it also has other things, like if we see what it also offers, then we have a lot of other things like create ticker and everything, dispose and everything. We don't actually need them. So this is the main thing which you need. You can show, and now if I will refresh it, then it will show the top indicator, and then the list is refreshed. So that is about the pull to refresh. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then do like the video, do subscribe to the channel if you're not the subscriber, and also make sure to check the source code from the description and the other repositories, and also the Facebook group. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.